sam opet pravila publikaciju o skupini 143. In potem kot sporedno s tem je nastala ta razstava. Knjiga bo zdaj pridružila pač prišla med nas v jeseni. Razstava pa prinaša v bistvu dokumentarni material, neki zbrani projekti so tukaj povečani, neki potem tega materiala na papirjih, knjige umetnika, dokumenti in drugo gradivo. V spodnjih prostorih so pa videi in videodokumentacija. Nekaj v tej skupini si si že prebral v prejšnji informaciji. Osebno se mi je zelo zanimivo to skupino povabiti v predstav, ki je namreč za prvo predstavitev te skupine v Ljubljani, kjer je v bistvu prijateljevala tudi skupino Oko. Na nekaterih manifestacijah so celo tudi sodelovali in skupina tudi prve skupina Oko. In potem svojo kariero so zaključili v 1980 v Galeriji Loža, to je bila njihova zadnja razstava. Tako da ta v bistvu zbrani material, in tudi knjiga pa ne bi v bistvu malo osvetlila delo te skupine, ki je v bistvu en tak radikalen konceptualizem, malo drugačen od drugih konceptualizmov, ki so se pojavljali, oziroma ki jih poznamo in smo se v njih učili. Zdaj bi pa predal seveda besedo Dismarju, da spregovori nekih pač podatkov o tem splošnem kontekstu skupine in če imate boljše vprašanje, kar na plani, ne?
Continuing in English, I couldn't understand more or less the things you were saying. So the last time these things, and not in all of them, were exhibited. It was 30 years ago in Koper, in Galerija Loža. Loža.
Loža.
Loža. That's it.
Yes.
So it somehow come back 30 years later to Slovenia. The group 143 is called 143 for some simple reasons. It was founded in Belgrade on the 14th of March. So there's no mysticism in this.
Like the gallery P74.
So 14th of March, founded actually by Biljana Tomić, whom maybe you know, she's active until now in the present, having her project in Belgrade. As part of, it was thought to be not an artistic group, like we are meeting each other and producing art, but we are meeting together in an open platform. People could join us when they're interested in actual questions in art. So the focus is on questions, the focus is on theory in art, the focus is on modern tendencies in late conceptual art. So the American or Anglo-American conceptual art movements were quite over at this time already. So the big exhibitions were taking part in the first part of the 70s. And maybe a little bit later in Belgrade, because it was some kind of reaction to the so-called great conceptual artists like Raša Torosijević, Marina Abramović, Neša Paripović, so the group of the six artists. These guys were 10 years or so younger and interested especially on art theory and art as theory. So not art as producing aesthetic objects, but through theories. So which theories? Language philosophy was one of the key moments. Wittgenstein, of course, very important. So there are some very simple statements they were following, but following very, very strictly. So these are not ironic or funny or humoristic works. They're really, really strict and serious young guys, which were not happy with the artistic education in their environment, let's say the academies in Belgrade at this time. So what does Wittgenstein say, for example, and they took it very seriously, when you understand something, you have to say it loudly. When you don't understand it, you have to quiet. So very, very simple. And they put it further to combine it with system theories, with the tradition of abstraction through the 20th century. So the goal is to come to some zero point of expression, like the whole art movement with the paintings or the high modernist movements, which Clement Greenberg, of course, was speaking about, dealing with emotion, dealing with the artist who can understand this world better than we do, and the artist is explaining the world to us. So these guys were not believing in this and said this is completely bullshit, we are seeing the same world you are doing, but we are reading a lot of books, we are concerned with the modern theories in like which are available now, cultural theories, so Barthes, Foucault, and French structuralist theories, where nobody in this time in Serbia or Yugoslavia was speaking about. They were reading these things and said, no, what our professors are doing is some old fashioned, not very interesting way of thinking. So this thinking is manifested through different media. So it was one of the core ideas is that if you have some idea or some concept or some system or some mental process, they're calling it like this, you can speak about it in different language models. One language model could be the photograph, another one could be the film, another one could be the books and the drawings and the diagrams. So the diagrams are the more of the basic language systems maybe, and if you combine them with aesthetic or visual systems, it becomes more and more complex, of course. This would mean like a work like this. You could also do it as a diagram, you could also do it like a film, you can also just speak about it, but the core idea is not changing. So, of course, nowadays I think these things are having some different aesthetic qualities through the time of 30 years. They are looking really great now, even better than they were supposed to look at this time. So we cannot avoid this like aesthetic value after 30 years, but it was not meant like this, but this was strictly seen as documents, process, recordings, so we are speaking about process and not about final result, processes of thinking, which are manifested in the pictures and maybe even more in the films you can see in the other room. There are three films done by the group, one after Wittgenstein's theory, one is dealing with the theory of the Prague linguistic circle, and one is about the theory of colors from clay. So these are the basic ideas. What else to say? They were working together for 5 years, so we have worked, they did really together as a group, as some alternative to the school, as I already said, in where they were living, like in Belgrade, and they are not artists by profession. They were studying electrotechnics, mathematics, and machine engineering. So they did not go through the whole artistic process of artistic formation, which is maybe also interesting. So you can see it in the diagrams, maybe, or in this very mathematical way of thinking and showing ideas. Yeah. So that's actually the basic idea of the group. They were not very happy, of course, afterwards with the coming back of painting art with the Italian trans avant-garde and the German neo-expressionism at the beginning of the 80s. So it is somehow the last examples for radical conceptual art from this whole region of space, I believe Yugoslavia as well, let's say Yugoslavia. After that, conceptual art was somehow gone. If it came back afterwards with neo-conceptual art and in which variations, you can discuss about this, but these were the last authentic, let's say, tries in this region to do works like this in a very strict analytical, hard, conceptual manner. Miško Šuvaković, he was the leading figure of the group. It's like monography. And we looked and I think
it was just published 2 days ago.
Yeah.
So it's quite new.
And there will be a book on the